Today's video, I will show you how you can report on leads and deals that you have generated from your trade show.
Welcome to the Elixir channel, your resource for all things HubSpot.
I will be showing you three reports. The first one will be the leads that you have generated from your trade show. The second one will be the deal revenue that you have gained from your trade show. And the third one will also be regarding deals. It will be the forecasted revenue that you can break down based on the trade show or based on the month. So first things first, you need a sales pipeline. It can be a simple pipeline with multiple stages. The second one is a custom property that I've created where you can assign the trade show where you have generated your lead from. This property will be on the company level, and I created this property called First Trade Show, so it indicates where I have generated this lead. And for this one, I created 5 fictional trade shows, one for automotive, one for technology, one for AI, another one for manufacturers, and the last one would be for industrial chemicals with the timestamp to indicate when this trade show took place. And then we can start with the reports. So first I will show you the reports that I have already created, and then afterwards I will go through them one by one on how you can create these. So to explain you a bit of the report. So this report shows you the amount of leads that you have generated from your trade show. Obviously a lead doesn't always remain a lead. Sometimes they go through the life cycle stages, such as here we can see that a few of them became an opportunity and a few of them even became a customer. So what I've done here is I took the trade show that I put on the XS, and it indicates each trade show. So it breaks down each trade show. And then on the YS, I put the amount of leads that I've generated per trade show. As you can see here, it nicely shows how many leads I've generated per trade show, with a breakdown of the life cycle stage they are currently. For the second one, I create a report where I can see the deals that I have closed. So this is deals that have been signed and that have become a customer. So in this case, I have here the true trade shows where I have 2 closed deals from. One from Carrefour and one from Eon Projects. And then the third one here, this is a forecast. And the forecast is based on the deals that I expect to close in the future. Obviously, not every deal will close. So therefore, in the pipeline, we use the weighted amount. And this shows the weighted amount per deal with a breakdown in which stage the deal takes place. Or well, the deal is present. Okay, so now I will go to the report builder. And for this instance, I will use the custom report builder because I want to use some multiple objects. So first, we will start with the leads generated from the trade show. And for this one, we only need companies. So I will use as my primary data source companies. And then we can start building the report. You can choose which type of chart you want to use. I will use the vertical bar because it's the easiest one for me. And first we will make sure that we report on the trade show. So I want to see where I generate the lead from. So I will use the first trade show. So as you can see, it shows you the 5 trade shows that I have listed in the dropdown. I also see a no value, and we want to make sure that we don't include those that we didn't generate from trade shows. So you make sure that you set a filter by saying that the first trade show should be no. And then the second thing is that you want to know how many leads you've generated. So for this instance, we will use a property that is used on every company, and that will be the create date, because the create date should always be no. And there we go. So here you can see the amount of leads that you've generated per trade show. And as you can see, it says distinct count. We don't want to have this on our report, so we can change the name of this label. Cool. And then finally, we also want to see the lifecycle stage they're currently in. So you look for the lifecycle stage and that you drag under breakdown by. And now it shows you the breakdown of each lifecycle stage. So that is our first report. So it needs generated for TRADESHOW. I will save this report. Do not want to add this to a dashboard, and let's say that I only can see it for now. So there we go. Now we have a nice first report. All right. So let's create our second report. We will also use the custom report builder. And for this one, we will use two data sources. The first data source will be the deals, because we want to report on the amount of revenue that we've generated, the deal amounts, the deal revenue rate that we generate from trade shows. And we will also use companies because we store our trade show data on company level. And then what we will do now here is that we also want to see per trade show how much our organization has generated in terms of revenue. So for this one, we will use the trade show, the first trade show property again. Put this on the X axis. Again, you can choose which chart you want to use, but I use the vertical bar one. And for this instance, again, we want to make sure that this property is always filled in. So we will set as a filter, first ratio is known. And then all we have to do is we want to report on closed deals. So we will do deal amount. So just normal amount or company currency, drag this to the Y axis, rename this to deal amount. Cool. And then all we have to do is apply another filter. We want to make sure that we have the right pipeline. And in this case will be the sales pipeline. And we also want to make sure that the stage is closed one, because we want to ensure that we only have closed deals in this report. Well, there we go. Here you can see the generated amount. Again, you can use a breakdown, and this breakdown that can be you can either have the deal name so that you see each deal, or what you could also do is you can the company name, and then you can break down. So these are two options. For this case, I will use the deal name. So this report, we will use closed revenue ratio. And then the final one is you also want to have like an idea of how much revenue is in the pipeline in nearby future. So we will build a similar report. So we need as primary data source the deals, and then the secondary would be companies. And for this instance, we want to forecast the deal. So what we will do now is that we will, let's say, report on the months. So we want to show the months at the bottom and the X axis. We name this to months, and we want to forecast the amounts. So we will do, instead of the closed amount, we will use the weighted amount. The weighted amount will drag here, the Y axis. Go. as you can see, there are a lot of dates that shouldn't be there. So we want to make sure that the close date is more than one day from now. So you have an idea of future. The pipeline. At the sales pipeline in this case. And then as the final one, you want to show the trade shows maybe. So you want to break down a trade show and to ensure that all only from trade shows, you make sure that first trade show is known. So there you go. So now you will nicely see that all the months are after the day from now. So in this case, July. So it will be August, September, October, November, and so on. You also break down per trade show and you see the deal amount at the top, the forecasted deal amount that is in your pipeline. This forecasts per month from trade show. We save this report and now we created three nice reports. The first report is about the leads that you've generated. The second report is the closed deal revenue that you have generated. And the third report is the forecast amount per month, all related to your trade shows.